the functional scoliosis is there will be any compensatory due to leg length inequality or pelvic unleveling, and maybe due to posture, because it caused because of the muscle imbalance, and transient, it may be due to pain they are taking to one recovery positions, or due to pain response, avoidance of pain. These are the positions like avoidance of pain. If they have any disc prolapse, and this particular patient, what I shown in the screen, that the right side of hip joint, which is going to one side, and the left side of shoulder, which is going to another side. This particular patient who is preparing for his NDA examination, so I have a target to give him a good posture in this, that is within this next month. So now also the patient is continuing the treatment, but what are all the treatment protocol we actually designed for him, and what are all the improvements we got with our protocols? That only I am going to discuss with this. This is my first case I showed here, and how to assess the functional scoliosis. For the structural scoliosis, we see all the pops angle in scoliosis and other angles, riser signs, lot of things are there. But to differentiate the structural scoliosis and functional scoliosis, we have only one test, that is Adams forward bending positions. Adams forward bending position. That is this Adams forward bending position, that ask the patient to bend forward and see whether the deviated parts, which is coming towards the medial aspect, that is middle portion, and if you see the straight curvature in the spinal cord. So always the spinal curvature straightens out, and there is no evidence of rib humping. So we can say that the test is negative. It is the test positive for the functional scoliosis. Functional scoliosis means we can correct. Even structural scoliosis also we can correct with the orthotic devices, but some curvatures we can correct, not all the curvatures. Because in the structural scoliosis we have three curvatures, upper, lower, and the middle one. So any one of the thing you will correct, not all the three. So going to the postural assessment, in upright stance, we see the head position relation to the body, and the relative heights of the shoulders and pelvis, and any spinal lift or rotation should be noted. Since the corrective exercises may be needed, that's why we see the spinal lift or the rotations. What you seen in the second diagram, that is first case of mine, that is showing the spinal lift and the rotations. Then I will show you the x-ray of the patient also. You will clearly see the rotations of the vertebra. In the functional scoliosis, frequently associated with the leg length inequality, always you will see this. Why? Because of the listing, they try to elevate the hip joint, and that's why we are going to see the unleveling of the pelvis. In which side the listing is there, that side the patient shows the elevated pelvic area or elevated iliac bone. So on that side they have a shortness, and the other side there will be a drop of pelvis. In that side you see the lengthening of the leg. And excessive pronation of one or both of the feet. Yes, yes, I seen this pronation in my patient. That I will show you. So this is the pronated foot, how a pronated foot it is. That is the calcaneum will deviate towards the medial side, and you will see a flat foot in the medial side, that is medial longitudinal arch. The center one, which is showing the normal foot, the calcaneum, which is straight, and the tibia, which is articulated well along with the calcaneum. The supinated foot is, that we say it is a piscavus, and the patient bear more weight on the lateral border of the foot. The lateral border of the foot. In the pronated foot, the patient bear all the weight on the medial side of the foot. So due to hyperpronation, what will happen? The pelvis to drop to the more pronated side. Pelvis always drop to the more pronated side during stance and gait. And this resulting the lateral pelvic tilt lowers the sacral base and drops the lowest freely movable vertebra to the side of the shorter leg. So whenever we are getting a list to one side, towards that list side, the fifth lumbar vertebra also will move along with that. So when the lumbar vertebra will move along with the pelvis, there will be a compression of that L5 nerve root. So that's why to avoid that pain, patient always lean their body on the shorter side. That is the way they to avoid the pain. On the elevated side, they drop their shoulder on the same side of the list. So in the area of pelvic drop, they have somewhat shifted at the elevated shoulder. The spinal curvature, lateral spinal curvature, develops in the lumbar spine due to lack of balance and support from the lower extremities with every step. So yes, always there will be a unleveling of the pelvis. Because of that, we have a lumbar spine curvature, that is lateral tilt of the lumbar spine curvature. So along with this responses, various compensatory pelvic lift and sacroiliac subluxation complexes have been found to develop a posterior rotation of the innominate bone, often develops on the side of the longer side. So if the functional curvature progresses to involve the thoracic region, it may demonstrate a mild rib hump which disappears upon correction of the leg discrepancy. So all these characteristics you are going to see now, all the characteristics my patient is having. The first case which is having all these things, posterior rotation of the innominate, because of this the patient always keep the hip joint in flexion position. So because of the hip joint flexion, again the patient show a knee joint flexion. So in order to avoid the pain over that area. And finally, this is the patient having a rib hump over the thoracic area. Yes, he is having a rib hump in that. And the lumbar spine, lateral curvature will be there. And pelvic list is there. Sacroiliac subluxation, even after this many years, I also don't know that how to differentiate the sacroiliac subluxation, but I'm a little bit confused in this. So don't ask me more question in the sacroiliac subluxation. Okay. And yes, obviously we are having a lateral pelvic tilt. So now these are all the compensatory actions we see due to the muscle imbalance. Here in the diagram, you see the right side is pronated foot. Along with this right side, the right side tibia also internally rotated. Because of this, they are going to keep the femur or the knee joint in a valgus position. So the femur also internally rotated. So because of this, that side pelvis is going to drop down. Automatically, the opposite side which is going to elevate. So in which side they are having an elevated ilium, that side shoulder will droop. In which side they are having a dropped pelvis, that side shoulder will raise. So this compensations we see in the patient. Okay. So in which side they are having an elevated ilium, so that side shoulder will drop. Mostly that side only the patient have the list. Listing is the shifting of the pelvis. Shifting of the pelvis towards one side. Listing. Along with that, the lower vertebra of the lumbar area also move along with that listing. So there will be a impingement on the L5-S1 area and L4-L5 area. So this is my patient. One, the patient name is here, but I am not going to spell the patient name. And he is a student preparing for the MBA examination and unmarried. obviously he is a student, so most of the time they are unmarried. And this particular patient we studied from 28th May to till date. It is not 13th June till today morning. And the patient age is 17 years and education is +2 and address is Dehradun. The patient visited the clinic Dehradun with a complaint of continuous pain at the lower back and which is traveling to the right side limb, lower limb. And the postural deviation he is having at the glutes, shoulder area postural deviation with more than 6 years of history of deviation. And their parents, they think that the boy is walking sideways. So that's why they have not noted whether he is having scoliosis or not, because he is a football player also. So the parents, they have to look at the earlier age, even though we can start a rehabilitation at the earliest stage itself. But they are not noted. They thought that being a boy, he might be walking very stylishly, like they thought and lived it. Okay. So that is now the parents' fault also. So stiffness and functional disability is the add. So this is a X-ray I got from the patient. So this is his old X-rays. See the cervical area. Okay, AP view, lateral view, and the lumbar area. Here if you are seeing, so this is the central area, the center area where I marked, those are the spinous process of the cervical and thoracic area. See the alignment of the spinous process is not in the line. The center area here, see here, center area. So the spinous process is here, one side, this means the spine of the vertebra, that is cervical vertebra, is rotated to one side. It is the spinous process is right side rotated, right side rotated, particularly the C4, C3, C2, all the above vertebras. And if you are seeing the lumbar area, see the spinous process which is not in one line in the center of the body of the vertebra. See the body of the vertebra. Easily you can see all the mammillary process, the transverse process. Okay, see the line, it's straight line. The spinous process of the lumbar vertebra, which is not aligned in the one straight line. So this is a postural evaluation we did. Okay. See the left side of the patient's shoulder, which is deviated one side, and the right side of hip joint or the iliac bone, which is shifted to another side. This only I showed in the first area. And in the second diagram, which is showing that there is a bit dump here. Okay, so this is showing the patient is having a elevated ilium or a depressed shoulder and the side, right side. So this one compensation we already discussed, we see. Now you see the pronation at the left side. The pronation is at the left side. In the pronation left side, so 1 minute, 1 minute. Sir. வணக்கம் சார். சார் வெபினார்ல வெபினார் முடிஞ்சு பண்ணுமா சார்? ஓகே சார், நான் பண்றேன் சார். ஓகே, சாரி ஃபார் தட் இன்டரப்ஷன். மை பிஹெச்டி கைட் டாக்டர் நர்கீஷ், ஹி வாஸ் ஆன் த லைன், ஸோ ஐ ஷுட் நாட் ரிஃப்யூஸ் த கால், ஸோ ஐ அட்டெண்டட் இட். ஓகே, ஸோ வி கண்டினியூ வித் த ஸ்லைட்ஸ். த ப்ரொனேஷன் அண்ட் த லெஃப்ட் சைட் ஃபுட். So the shorter, that is the pronated leg and pelvic drop side. Pelvic drop side, the pronation is more. And the second diagram, which is showing the patient is having a flexion at the hip joint. More flexion at the right side. So this hip joint also, which is elevated, is the pronation here and the flexion at the hip joint. Hip and knee joint. And see, this is the first diagram which is showing the elevated hip joint. So because of the flexion at the hip joint, he is not able to keep his ASIS down on the bed. So the patient also walked with a flexion at the hip joint. And here I am showing this how it is deviated. The second diagram showing that how the spine is deviated. See, it is deviated towards the left side. The C curvature type. Now I can show you again. So here in the diagram, which is clearly shown data, when we evaluated that, also asked the patient to do the movement. Now the right side hand is flexion. See the S-shaped curvature. This is a S-shaped curvature. See how we used to. Okay. So what I did the right side should come backward. So here in the second diagram, I shown the right side is back. See the curvature. So I advised it. Mostly you do the extension at the right side shoulder with TheraBand. Extension at the right side shoulder. More extension. And flexion at the left side. Again with the TheraBand. So this I told to the patient to continue with this. Now this exercise we added now only. That is yesterday we saw that we have to go with the pelvic motion. So we did this before also. We concentrated on the pelvic motion, particularly the quadratus lumborum. But he told that he was performing at the home, but we are not believing in it. So today we assess this. I think yesterday I assessed this. The weight shifting on the body. So the first diagram, the patient shifting the weight on the right side, see the curvature. It is straight. And after that, the patient is shifting the weight on the left side. The curvature is somewhat showing C shape of curvature. So we should avoid the second diagram exercise. We always insist the first diagram exercise, ball exercise. This is the Swiss ball exercise. So, in which he is getting the good compensation, that is straight curvature. That exercise we are going to advise more. So, what I did in this patient, I given a medial arch support. Yes, medial arch support. He told him to wear in both the side of the foot. And releases. What at the lumborum release I did? Iliopsoas. I did erectospinae muscles we released, and along with this, in this patient I am alone, not treated. My subordinates, my students, and my colleagues, my friends, so then we have 3-4 physios in our clinic. Recently we had a group discussion with the patient and we applied all the things on this patient. So daily I don't treat the patient, particularly this particular patient. So other people, they help me to do all these corrections. And modalities, yes, sometimes we applied IFT also in case we have more patients. At time we applied 10 to 15 minutes of IFT also. Cupping, yes, in order to correct the shoulder or pull the shoulder, so we did a cupping from the left side and left right side of the shoulder and left side of the iliac region. So right side and left side we pull like that. So and exercises, yes, a retractor of the shoulder, yes, you've seen in the diagram, retractor and extensor of the shoulder and hip. So both we did. And the home program TheraBand exercises, I advise him to do the TheraBand exercises, retractor extensor, the shoulder, okay, extensor, shoulder and the hip, both the things, retractor of the shoulder movement. Along with this, now I advise the patient to do the ball exercise, that That is the Swiss ball exercise. See the patient, how he is going to perform, whether you will get a good video or not, I don't know, with sound or without sound. See this. So right side, whenever patient is moving towards right side, see. Left side, that is left side weight bearing. C-shaped curvature. Anterior and posterior tilts. So this way we advise the patient to do the exercises. Mostly he tried to put all the weight on the right side glutes, weight bearing on the right side. Whenever he is keeping his weight on the right side glutes, the spine which is coming straighter. So that's why we advise. Suppose if still the pain continues, the mobility and stability exercises which decrease the mobility exercises and stability exercises, which is going to maintain the particular condition. This is not only here we are going to do, but in every conditions after the releases we are going to teach them the mobility and stability exercises, because here because of the pain this is going to decrease, and the muscle strength which is going to decrease, coordination going to decrease, proprioceptions which is going to change, and all these problems combinedly going to give somatic disorder problems. So in order to avoid all those things, release, and after that you do the strengthening exercises, and also the postural adjustment we have to correct, and individual muscle release and individual muscle strength improvements you can do with the TheraBand or some other mechanical things you can use, any other gadgets you can use. And activity, increase the activity. All those things we did, that is about the first patient. Now we are treating, still we are treating this patient. So, but most of the thing we corrected. Most of the thing we corrected. Now we come to the case 2. Again, he is a 40-year-old patient. He is a teacher and also a level 1 cricket coach, and still he is working in Kendra Vidyalaya and Kendra Vidyalaya Dehradun. So we treated him from 11th May 2018 to 3rd July 2018. So near about 23 days, I think we treated him. So that only I am going to show you here. The patient again visited the clinic with a complaint of continuous pain at the lower back. So he visited so many clinics. After that, he came to our clinic and he complained about a pain at the glutes and shoulder area. More than 5 months of history of pain, stiffness and functional disability. So the complaints, what are all the complaints he did? Severe pain, not able to sit for a long time, not able to bend the back, not able to sleep properly, not able to attend a social gathering, and not able to concentrate. So this all the problems he had. So we did a radiographic analysis, numerical pain rating scale we taken, and the LBA disability scale as well as three low back pain disability scores we take. And the treatment, what are all the treatment we given to the patient? The transverse friction erector spinae to the transverse friction to the erector spinae about 10 minutes. My facial releases, particularly again quadratus lumborum, erector spinae, and psoas muscle. and we given stretch means a reverse stretch, 5 repetition with the 30 second hold. Reverse stretch. So this is how we apply the erector spinae muscle transcription over the erector spinae muscle and psoas release at the psoas area. So here we are going to release the psoas fascia, not the psoas muscle. So if you, once we are releasing the fascia, we are automatically going to release the muscle also. So lay the cross and release again the myofascial release. This is a bony clearing of the iliac crest. This is one of the technique for quadratus lumborum muscle. And quadratus lumborum release again release, because in quadratus lumborum we have three fibers. One is the longitudinal fiber, another two are the diagonal fibers, the upper diagonal and the lower diagonal. So to release the diagonal fibers, we do this quadratus lumborum release. So the interpretation of scores of that, especially low back pain disability, that is this trend, 0 to 20% or 21 to 40%, 41 to 60% and 61 to 80%. So 78%, total score is 78%. That means the patient is coming with a severe disability to crippled. So this many things we had over that year. So we measured about the pain intensity, personal care, lifting, walking, sitting, standing, sleeping, sexual life, social life, traveling, everything. And this is on the day he came to our clinic. So total score, again, the day 23rd day, we came to 38%. See how much we decreased. 38% to 38%, 40% of the ability we provide to the patient. What we want, this only we want, the functional improvement to the patient, the able to do his normal work. This is in the disability score, and this is the numerical rating scale. See, on first day he came with 80% of pain, and on the day of 23, he had 40%. About 40% of the pain again he reduced. The 4 is will come like a minimal bearable pain only. 0 to 3, 4 is it will come moderate pain. 0 to 3 is a minimal. See, we did something, we did pain reduction also, we did disability, we reduced. Okay, we improved. Be given an ability. So this is what I discussed before. And see this on day one. See it's a lumbar area. How it is exactly? It is a S-shaped curvature. L5 area you see, sacral area, L4, L3, L2, L1, koya, dusre disha mein ja raha. S-shaped. See here. So on day 1, on day 23, what we did, we asked the patient to take the x-ray. Sorry for this x-ray display, because my patient name also which has been displayed in this, ignored, okay. So the patient, I should not show that, okay, by mistake it has been keen. So see this. Day 23, near about the straight curvature. Though we are not want that much of real curvature, but a physiotherapist can do. The only thing is you have to keep it in mind. I can do. If I am able to do, means you can also do that. This is. After that only I had the confidence that any functional scoliosis patient I will treat. Okay, first thing is I have to confirm that whether it is a functional scoliosis or not. Whether it is a functional scoliosis or the structural scoliosis. So case 3 is now he is coming to the clinic. We did 2 days, 2 weeks ke baad, after 2 weeks we did the x-ray. See this x-ray. The first one is showing the first day, that is in which day he came to me, the 2 weeks before he came to me. Now after 2 weeks, this is the x-ray on June 22nd. See the difference, AP view there. Okay, here you are seeing a C curvature or the lumbar area. Here you see in the lower lumbar area we corrected, not in the upper lumbar area. Now I am trying to give him the improvement in the upper lumbar area. So maybe after 2 weeks I might reach a very good improvement. I will give a very good improvement to the patient. Maybe. Okay. So why we have to do the psoas muscle release? Because of the direct attachment of the psoas in the lumbar spine. Tightening of the muscle, which is going to give you increased lumbar lordosis. If you have a increased lumbar lordosis, then the patient always have a tightened erector spinae. You will see a valley sign. So you have to release the erector spinae and release the psoas muscle. And this is I showed the reason for how the iliopsoas working and kis-kis mein kaam karti hai. During the toe out gate, how it works, like the psoas muscle tends to move, then there will be increased lumbar lordosis. It is going to compress the posterior elements at the lumbar area. So we apply transfection to the erector spinae muscle. Yes, why? Because it facilitates the proliferation of the fibroblast and results in the facilitation of a soft tissue healing and a realignment as pressure applied to the muscle is increased. And the quadratus lumborum releases, we given, yes, we have to do. And poor posture and body positioning alters the body mechanics, which results in development of motor trigger point in this muscle and results in low back pain. So because of that, we release the quadratus lumborum. So through MFR we release that. So MFR always having analgesic effect and work both on the spinal and the supraspinal area. And through that, it is going to give nociceptive inhibition. The system will continue. The process will go on like a dorsal horn of the spinal cord, which is going to close the gate over that area because of the mechanoreceptor stimulation. And also MFR encourages the circulation of fluid around the area. So not only MFR, any mechanical pressure you give on the area of dysfunction, so which is going to increase the blood circulation by the microcirculation over that area. If circulation is increasing over that area, you are going to provide good oxygenation over that area. So if oxygenation is there, then patient always get a good relief from the dysfunction. So that only we are going to create. So again, this is also the some of the evidences for the MFR, how we apply and what effects it is giving. So again, to the myofascial release, because I am one of the myofascial release therapists, so that's why I pasted all the MFR evidences. But any soft tissue release you can use, and you can give the evidence of this, all the evidences to any soft tissue release. So in conclusion, what we see in our case studies, the myofascial release techniques, along with the transverse friction, were safe and effective. This is going to provide long-lasting effects on the symptoms of low back pain, not only low back pain and the functional scoliosis over a period of 2 months on pain, posture and functional ability. So, along with this, we have to do corrective exercises, whether you can use TheraBand or the Swiss ball activities. Okay. So, all this synergism should work on the treatment of a low back pain as well as in the low back pain stimulated functional scoliosis. Okay, low back pain stimulated functional scoliosis or the functional scoliosis stimulated low back pain. Vice versa, we can take. Because nobody come to you with a diagnosis of functional scoliosis. Always the patient come to you with a low back pain complaint. So whenever you are undressing them and seeing the spinal curvature, then only you come to know that whether they are having the scoliosis, that to be structural or functional. So that is about the presentation. These are the references I used for this presentation. This is some of the references we used for this particular things. And the compensations I taken it from the AmericanChiropractor.com website. Yes, I accessed on 9th. So I prepared this presentation on 9th of this month. So thank you very much for your precious time. Thank you so much. Himanshu. Dr. Himanshu. Over to you, Dr. Himanshu. Hello.
Can you see the chat?
Yeah, I'm able to see the chat. Yes, yes. I just go with the chat box. I'm not able to access that chat box. Very informative. Thank you. Selvam sir, Ponsa Selvam sir, my senior Selvam sir means it's good. Thank you very much, sir. Yeah, I think it will be a good informative session for you. I hope you can ask more questions also. So what this three patients only I seen in my clinic, and but more if more patients if we see or if you are seeing any patients, then we can have a discussion and what are all the things we can give like. Yes, we are doing a very good work. The thing is, the physio, they never know that we are doing a good work. Always keep on some records along with you. Always you keep records. I think Dr. Himanshu, he came back.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very
and,
much, Agmash.
Great question and great explanation and great question on the topic. We have learned a lot and it was an excellent session. We have enjoyed a lot for the day. And even though, sir, I am again very thankful to you for cooperating. I just have some network trouble and I was left out. Wonderful session. Do we have some queries here? Because as I have rejoined, the chat has been removed from my end. Yeah, I would request anybody that can write down the chat box. Yeah, there is a question. Can you see I should have it?
Which one? And the very first one.
I just joined, so previous chats are not available.
Can we see the patient of misalignment? What? Mobilization? No. It is not only mobilization. See, misalignment, what I want to say this, the functional scoliosis is due to a problem in the muscles. Okay, you work on the muscles. If at all, if you want to align the bones, you can align it, no problem. I am not against this chiropractic. We can align the bones with your adjuster. Okay, or manually you can adjust. So anyway, you can do that. In which you are having a very good result, that you will follow. I did, I don't know chiropractic. I know osteopathy. Okay, because I am a myofascial therapist. So myofascial therapy is a osteopathy technique. So whatever soft tissue releases we did, so that improvement only I showed you. Yeah. A quadratus lumborum is tight, then that side will be shorter. Yes. That side, they will raise the pelvis. If the pelvis is coming up, always you will have a shortening over that area. See, for the structural and the functional scoliosis, we have to see whether they have any structural problems or not. Any vertebra or in the pelvis itself, you have a shorter pelvis. All those things you have to see. They are ligament problems. So once you are squaring the pelvis, after that, that thing get corrected means you have to go only with the pelvic area. So correction is corrected. With the correction itself, you are getting a good improvement means. So no need to go to the muscles. But my question is, after correction, if you are not doing any strengthening exercise to the muscle, again, which is going to come to the misalignment only. So my here, I want to specify that don't you fix with only one technique. You have to go with the integrations. That only in the first slide itself I showed you. Integrate it. Whether it is osteopathy, physiotherapy, or chiropractic, anything you can do. Yes. The Lalita. Then the scoliosis is over lengthened or shortened the leg and rib hump would be on convex side. Yeah, rib hump will be convex side. Only the rib hump which is coming due to the rotation of the vertebra. So that rotation you are going to correct it. Yes, we do did that sleeping position to my first case. And in which side he get that listing. So that side we given a what we say that round pillow, gold takia. Apply karke, then unko late nikale bola. But whether he is doing at home or not, I don't know. But in the clinic, we make that position for half an hour. Because in my mind, I will always try that I have to go to other technique if one technique is working. then that is one of the positions we do in a positional release therapy. So I'll position it. That particular photograph I'm not included in this because one of my subordinates, she is not included that. She is, was also busy in the morning. So she has not taken photographs in that. So sleeping position mostly on the listing side, we have to ask the patient to try to keep on pillow while sleeping. If after sleeping, whatever position he will go, God knows. What type of exercise should not be done with the scoliosis? See, this is shown in the diagram. So, in which exercise which is going to create that C-type curvature, those exercises always we should ban. It is possible to develop scoliosis by indulging in any sports for, let's say, badminton. Any sports, my first kid is a football player. He can do good flips. That's the functional scoliosis patient. He's a young guy. He do a lot of rotations with the legs, like a ball or some ball thing. He can do any sport. Try to maintain this continuous. Just in case it is beneficial to me, should I consider it a deformity? No pain in patient. What? See, if deformity is there, then you are going to definitely working for the deformity to reduce. To reduce the deformity, after that you improve their activities. The deformity, if you are increasing their activity, means no use. No use. That means you are playing with the patient. So first of all, we have to correct that positions, whatever the abnormal positions are there. So for that, what we are doing, that we are.
So I think we have done almost all questions.
Yeah, I see one of my old good friends, Amita. She is not here, I think. She is from outside. She is from Saudi.
Sir, actually you would be...
Tarun sir, Tarun from Malaysia. Thank you, Tarun sir. It's good to see you here. Thank you very much.
Ma'am is joining us from the Saudi Arabia.
Hey, my regards to Gulu also. I'm seeing Amita. How are you? Good, good. I repeatedly seeing you are attending every webinar. That is a very good job. Keeping on updating your knowledge. It's really keep up well. Very good to see you. You are as same, Amita. As same. Very good. Very good. Good. So, sir and Daniel sir, so हमेशा आते ही हैं एंड आई एम मिसिंग सुरेश सर सुरेश सर आई थिंक टुमारो इज दिस वेबिनार आई थिंक सुरेश सर
यस सर
सेम टाइम 9 to 10
यस सर 9 to 10
कपिला आल्सो देयर ओ हेलो यार गुड टू सी यू कपिला तरुण गुल्लू
Mohammad Asif from Pakistan. Amita, as you know, is joining us from the Saudi Arabia. Tarun is in Malaysia right now.
Yes.
And this
is our classmate only. Tarun, Jack, ye Swapnila, all our classmates.
Okay. And one more, Priyanka Mangalan, she is also from the USA.
That's good.
And
very nice.
My only Charman, you know. So we are really grateful to all the faculty members, even though in the starting, spenders. But I think there were some networks and there were lectures. And the Kalpana Jyoti ma'am from the Jamnagar and Jiran Munjal sir, both has also joined us. But in midway they have left because of some network issue. So it is really a matter of pleasure and honor. And this is aapka aashirwad se humne time nikala. Definitely, it is because of the Harsar. It's a unique guidance and everything is because of the Harsar. So always, I think they don't need to say thanks because it is just all them. Unke liye sab kuch. We are just the follower of you people. So we are just trying to do something as to following you because you are the pioneer of the physiotherapy field. So more of the physiotherapy students, professionals, or dream to like you in someday in the future. So we are grateful.
So next time we will come with more patients.
Thank you, sir.
Because of you, we came to this platform. Thank you so much for the opportunity. And thank you, Himanshu. I think you are alone on doing all the critical cutting works and gathering the people from various areas, various countries. Thank you so much for your effort. And keep doing the work always. It should be continuing after all. So.
Thank you, sir. Thanks. Thanks a lot for your compliments. And it's definitely a teamwork. As Arthur is there, everything is possible. So nothing is impossible if Arthur is there. So we are just doing the things. So thank you very much.
Sir.
And the last information, again,
bye bye. Amita, bye bye. Okay, bye bye, Himanshu.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye, thank you, sir.
We'll meet again tomorrow at 9 p.m. Till then, stay tuned, stay safe, good night, bye-bye.
Bye.